Hey, what's good, fam? It's Kyle Henderson of BamaInsider.com. Practice footage going into Georgia week. We start up with the running backs. As you can see, Charles Huff right there. We're going with the running backs. And how about the play of Brian Robinson as of late? Young man has really emerged into that back that we've been waiting to see. I think his performance over the last couple of games has really been noteworthy. And I think it's really propelled this Alabama ground unit to be one of the top imposing ground units in the country. Now you have to deal with Najee Harris. Now you have to deal with Brian Robinson. I think these guys coming into the season, we had those high expectations. It all starts with the big boys up front, and I think the offensive line has been doing a fantastic job through the first couple weeks of play. I think we really saw them come together against Ole Miss and really prove that if this team needs to run the football, they certainly can run the football against anybody. Big Deontay Brown, I thought he played fantastic in this last game, and here you see a couple of these younger guys, 71 Darian Dalcourt in the mix. Still waiting to see some of these younger wide receivers get into the field, but as you know, it's the SEC. It's you need all the starters in as much as you can, and rightfully so. Here's some more footage from this week of practice, and Alabama continues to gear up for Georgia. Will Daniel Wright step up? I think it's going to be a big opportunity for him. More footage of the offensive lineman right on the right, number 72. That's Pierce Quick. Offensive line getting in work. A lot of these younger guys are going to have to step up at some point. This is number 74, Damian George. And like I said, a lot of these freshmen, we really haven't seen play. Number 70 right there, Alex Otherwood. I thought he did well in these last couple of games. There's Deontay Brown again, number 65, along with Emil Ekior, number 55. As we continue to look at the footage, you got Jaylen Waddle. Got to think that he has to step up in this particular game. Yet to see Xavier Williams get onto the field this year. You got Chris Leonard out of Tuscaloosa, Alabama, number 84. And then you got Jaylen Waddle. I think when you look at players who are game breakers, Jaylen Waddle got to step up, right? Has to come up. And you're talking about guys who really have to step up. How about Mac Jones? And we'll talk about the stats in just a second. Really only have seen Bryce Young in that first game against Missouri. Still have not seen Paul Tyson. All these guys, you got to be ready. I mean, look what happened with Nick Saban, right? Getting a positive case of COVID. So at any moment, you got to be able to go in. But it's clear right now that Mac Jones is the guy. And I think when Bryce Young gets another opportunity, I think he's going to do just fine for the Alabama Crimson Tide. As we look at game breakers, got to think Devontae Smith, Jaylen Waddle. Those are the guys that really need to step up. And, of course, Najee Harris as well coming into this game. I think an important note when you look at Alabama and Georgia is that none of these guys have tested positive for COVID, knock on wood. I get it. You know, you're going into this season, but these players are tested every single day, and I think it's a positive overall that these players are healthy coming into this hard-hitting game against the Georgia Bulldogs. When we look at the overall stats, we'll start at the top, and we'll see that Najee Harris has 347 yards rushing with 10 touchdowns in three games. That's incredible, fam. You got Brian Robinson, as we just talked about, 154 yards with one touchdown. You look at kind of his average, 51 yards per game. I think those have been hard-earned yards that he's picked up. Really been playing fantastic through the later part of the season, these last two games. Mac Jones, his efficiency rating, 220. I believe it leads the country, 79% passing, 8 touchdowns, 1,100 yards on the season. I mean, this guy is playing through the roof, right? You look at the progression that we've seen from him. I think a lot of it comes from the continuity of having the same offensive coordinator. This is something that Alabama has not had over the last couple of years. That's why I think Steve Sarkisian has done such a fantastic job, and I think that's why if you're a fan out there, you got to be excited that he's leading this program into this Georgia game. Devontae Smith, 27 receptions, 316 yards with 2 touchdowns. Jaylen Waddle, 19 receptions, 396 yards with 3 touchdowns as well. Look at that average, 132 yards per game. And then John Metchie, welcome to the show, young man. 11 receptions, 298 yards with 2 touchdowns. As we continue to look at the individual stats, we see that interceptions on the team, Malachi Moore is a true freshman, has 1. And then Daniel Wright had a house call, 47 yards for a touchdown. Kick returns, Alabama has limited kick returns. You got Jaylen Waddle who has 2, Devontae Smith who has 2. As we look at the overall scoring leaders, you got Najee Harris with 10 touchdowns. That equates to 60 points. And then you got Will Reichert, who was 2 for 2, 21 for 21 on PATs, 27 points on the year. And I think Will Reichert, when you kind of look at the special teams game, he's got to have a big game against Georgia, right? 2 of 2. Let's see what he can do in a bigger game situation on the season, 2 for 2. Longest is from somewhere around, the inside of 30 to 39-yard mark. When we look at punting, Sam Johnson, 6 punts, 223 yards. That's an average of 37.2. And now we're looking at the overall defensive leaders from this team. You got Dylan Moses with 27 tackles with 3 games. You got Jordan Battle, who will be missing this first half of the game against Georgia due to a targeting call late against Ole Miss. He has 26 tackles. Christian Harris, a sophomore, 24 tackles. Daniel Wright, 19 tackles. And Malachi Moore is a freshman with 16 tackles. Hey, thanks for watching, fam. My name is Kyle Henderson of BamaInsider.com. Just days away between Alabama and Georgia. Get your mind right. It's time to go. Be sure and hit the thumbs up button, like, and subscribe. We'll catch you soon back at BamaInsider.com. Reporting from beautiful Tuscaloosa, Alabama, Kyle Henderson of BamaInsider.com.